Hello students, how are you and how's your study going on? I hope that you all will be fine staying home and doing your study at your home. On the behalf of Paramount Public School, today we are going to discuss the summary of chapter 1 of our book Snapshot. And the name of the chapter is The Summer of Beautiful White Horse. Are you ready to learn? Let's start with our topic. The Summer of Beautiful White Horse. This is a story of two tribal Armenian boys who belong to Garo-Ghalnain tribe or Garo-Ghalnain. For their family, it is the name of their tribe, Garo-Ghalnain. For their family, even in the times of extreme poverty, nothing could match the importance of honesty. It means that they belong to a poor family, but their family, because being a poor, they are also honest also. They never did anything wrong and never lied. It means they never spoken the lie or never even stole anything. The story talks about an incident that revolves around two cousins, Aram, who is 9 years old, and Murad, who is 13. Now, Aram is very fascinated by the world, as things are easy in childhood, because we have learned that Aram was 9 years old. Moreover, Murad is the crazy one, as everyone calls him. Firstly, we learn about their family, their tribe, their age, and their manners, how they behave. The story opens with Murad coming to Aram's house at 4 in the morning. It means at 4 o'clock. One fine day, and it was a fine day. He tapped on the window to Aram's room. When Aram looked out of the window, he was taken aback and startled. It means he got surprised very much to see Murad riding a beautiful white horse. In fact, he was so dazed that Murad had to say, "Yes, it is a horse." It means he was very surprised to see his cousin brother Murad on a white horse in the morning. When the day is beginning, he was surprised to see the situation. "You are not dreaming," this had said by Murad, that yes, it is a horse and you are not dreaming. All this was too unbelievable because Aram knew that they were too poor to be able to afford to buy a horse. It means they belong to a Garo-Ghalnain, a poor tribe, and they were too poor, so they couldn't afford to buy a horse. That's why Aram got more surprised than the ever. The only way Murad could possess it could be by stealing. They were too honest to lie and yet too crazy to ride a horse. It means they want to be honest also, that's why they don't want to tell a lie, but they too were very crazy also, that's why they wanted to ride a horse also. Thus, they kept the horse for 2 weeks, enjoying its ride in the cool air and singing in their hearts content on the country's roads. Then they hid it from the rest of the world. Rest of the world by keeping it in a barn of the deserted vineyard. Here barn means a deserted area or big building where we stored grain, straw or livestock, and vineyard where vines are grown. Meanwhile, Aram came to know that the horse was stolen from John Byro. Then they planned not to return it to him, So soon, although they had second doubts also about keeping it due to their ethics, because their ethics has told them that they are, whether they are poor, they can't lie, they can't steal. So they think about these two points. Finally, on one day, John sees the boys with the white beautiful horse. However, as his family was known for their honesty, John didn't accuse them of stealing. He didn't feel bad, or he didn't even remind that they had stolen the horse. On the other hand, his belief was so strong, and he just said that their horse resembles his horse a lot. Consequently, this was a very poignant experience for the boy. Poignant means sadness, regretness. They feel that why John Byrow is not calling them thief. He is saying that their horses are twins of his horse. Because they knew the truth, but John Byrow knew about their family background, that they are too honest from last many years. So they decide to return the horse, and John found it at the vineyard the next day. John gets very happy and shares the news with Aram's mother, who also see that his horse is now healthier, well behaved and more decent than before. So came to the conclusion. To sum up this chapter, we learn the significance and necessity of honesty even in the face of greed and desire. We must remain honest even we are in the greed, we are in the need, or if we want to fulfill our desire. Here, students, some words of vocabulary are given. Barn, it is not ban, barn, a large farm building used for storing grain, hay or straw, or for housing livestock. Vineyard, a piece of land on which vines are grown. Poignant, evoking a keen sense of sadness or regret. I hope, students, you got the summary. Thank you. Thanks for watching.